A very good morning to all our listeners. Welcome to The Voice on the Freshest Wave of Radio. I will ask you, the listeners, to pardon our voices. This morning, we've been in a tribal shooting conference 3 days and ministering, so our voices are kind of just crazy. But we still need to deliver the word of God and do what is needed. Thank you for all the callers. Thank you for the commitments that you guys are showing out there. It's a sign that God is making impact. This morning, I'm highly privileged to have the woman of God all the way from South Africa and Minister Pandora, based in Sandton, and she's going to be ministering to us this morning. And she's a woman who's well known, pronounced. You can catch her in one gospel. I'm sure she'll be able to tell us more about herself. Good morning, woman of God.
Good morning. Good morning, Patricia.
How are you today?
I'm blessed. It's an honor to be here. By grace. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you so much for availing yourself. I know it's not been easy. It's been very crazy and complicated, but I understand that we need to be here, and I know it's been very tiresome for you, but thank you for making time and coming to our program this morning. Maybe before we get into the word, kindly just give us a background of who Pandora Mabaya is.
I am a minister of the gospel of Christ. I call myself a messenger of God. Many people call me many things, but I prefer being called a messenger of God, because when you deliver the word of God to people, all you are just a vessel of God. You're just a messenger.
Yes.
I am an inspirational speaker. I am a coach in my country. I do a lot of work by grace of God with mass marketing, just to get the word of God out to the world, because God said, go out to the nations and preach the gospel. So in each and every platform that he gives me, let it be TV, let it be radio, let it be magazines, it is not about me. It is for the glory of God and for the gospel.
Amen.
To go out by grace.
Amen.
That is who I am. I am a member of Assemblies of God sent in under Pastor Manganyi. I am released by my church, and they have blessed me to be in Zambia.
Amen.
And I'm looking forward to going back home tomorrow.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. And so this morning, what exactly are we looking at, woman of God?
I've realized that in Africa, people are holding too much on prophecies that are being released, as I was talking last week about what it means to be prophets, and because it's one of the ministries in the fivefold ministries. But I think that Africa especially has misrepresented this ministry in so many ways, that it's denting the body of Christ, that it's misleading Christians, that everyone wants to be called a prophetess, everyone wants to be called a prophet. And interestingly, God had Ezekiel, had Jeremiah, had Deborah. These people were prophets and prophetess, but God never addressed them as prophetess or prophet. God called them by their names. So we need to bring correction to the body of Christ on how things are done biblically, because as servants of God, we need to align ourselves in everything that we do with the word of God. So as I was speaking to God, and I'm saying, God, in the correction that you're bringing to Africa, what do you want me to say to Zambia this morning? And God said to me, what I want you to say to Zambia is that preparation with God. In anything that anyone goes through, it is not a surprise to God. Life is never about events. Life is about the journey and the process and the seasons allowed by God in your life. God has given us four seasons in a year. In the four seasons, after winter must come spring. So it's never about your event. It's not about the season that you are in. In whatever season you find yourself in, you can find yourself in winter, in your marriage, in your finances, in your ministry, in your work. But trust God that after your winter, spring will come. It's about the journey, the destination, and the fact that God is with you. When I was speaking to God about preparation, God led me to many characters in the Bible, including our Messiah Jesus, that were prepared by God prior to their assignment. We can have a look at Moses, Jesus, John the Baptist, Esther, Mary, the mother of Jesus, each and every individual in just a few examples that I've given you. They were prepared by God for the journey upon their lives. But you see, the preparation of Mary, the mother of Jesus, and Moses really, really humbles me, because when we look at the book of Exodus, chapter 2, verse 10, it says, "And the child grew, and she brought him to Pharaoh's daughter, and he became her son. So she called his name Moses, saying, I drew him out of water." Maybe you did not know what the name Moses means. It means, I drew you out of water. So God is saying that he is drawing you out of your waters. In any situation, in any event that you find yourself in that looks like it is a situation that is too difficult for you, God is saying to you, he is drawing you out of water. Moses, his preparation humbles me in such a way that Moses, out of the kids that were being killed at the time in Egypt, God blessed his mother to keep him. And as he was kept, his mother thought, you know what, if I keep him any longer, a cry of this boy may draw attention to my house and I might end up killing my boy. But she had wisdom in the preparation for the assignment that was upon Moses' life. She had to put together a basket and put Moses in water. But you see, there was the preparation of Moses in order for him to go and do the assignment of God upon his life to set the Israelites free. So as he was sailing in his basket going, the daughter of Pharaoh picked him up. So it was all part of the preparation for the assignment that God had ordained for Moses. We can have a look at Mary as well, the mother of Jesus. I can only imagine what Mary was going through. Here she is. She is a virgin. She's never been touched by any man in her life. But God said to her, "You are a favored and a blessed woman amongst women." Here she is carrying a Messiah. The humiliation that she went through, her family not understanding. How can you be pregnant when you have never been with a man? I can only picture the scenario that Mary was going through. But you see, that was Mary's preparation to give birth to the Messiah. That was Mary's preparation to come and bring the one that was going to die for our sins. That was Mary's preparation for the assignment of God in her life. You see, I look at Pandora herself walking away from getting married to a multimillionaire and deciding literally a month away from her wedding day that, in fact, I do not want to do this anymore. It was all preparation for God's assignment upon my life. Mm. It has been 8 years since I walked away. Mm. When I had made a decision myself that, okay, fine, I've accepted this engagement. But when God has an assignment upon your life, amen, God will prepare you for the assignment. Amen. Walking away from the man that I was with, it was not an easy journey. Amen. Because when I look back, because now I'm in my 8th year, amen, when I look back to where I come from, amen, I had to sleep on the floors. Amen. I had to sleep without food sometimes. Amen. But when I look at where God, amen, has brought me, it was all part of the preparation. Amen. Hence today, I am able to stand on platforms that are opened by God, mm, to come and preach this gospel to the nations. Amen. Here I am from South Africa and I'm in Zambia. Mm. But 8 years ago, I did not see this. Amen. But it comes with obedience. Amen. You cannot be prepared by God without obedience. Amen. Pandora took the leap of faith and decided, amen, let me walk away from getting married to a multimillionaire that everyone thinks it is an achievement in life. Mm. You see, as an individual, mm, before you get get married or before you do anything in your life, you need to first find God, find your purpose, and then allow your husband to find you in God. But you see, when I was in the world, I was doing things outside of the word of God. So now that I know better, I am teaching, because my mess has been turned into a message to motivate and to encourage and to inspire you at home to set the captives free. So if you are in your preparation, I am saying that hold on to God in anything in life that needs to work in your life. You see, when you are being prepared, God is activating something in your life. Amen. You are probably asking yourself, but Pandora, what do you mean? What does the word activate mean? It means you make something operative in your life. You see, when you buy a cell phone, it's good as a cell phone. Without a SIM card, it's not going to work. So in South Africa, in my country where I come from, when you buy a mobile phone, you need to go and buy a SIM card. After buying a SIM card, you need to go with your identity, your ID, and your proof of payment. I mean, sorry, your proof of address. And you need to go recard that SIM card. So as you recard that SIM card, you are activating your phone to work. Jesus said in his word, if I do not leave, the helper, which is the Holy Spirit, will not come. So what am I saying to you this morning? In order for you to be able to be prepared, it starts with obedience, number one. Number two, you need to activate your SIM card. What is your SIM card? Your SIM card, it is for you to activate the Holy Spirit of God in you so that you are connected to the supernatural Wi-Fi, which is the heavens. So once you've got the Holy Spirit, you are able to discern, you are able to be vigilant, you are able to hear from God directly without prophets telling you who you are supposed to be. I am saying, Africa, step out of this thing of bowing down to prophets and prophetesses. They are not God. God is the one who said in the book of Jeremiah, I knew you before I formed you in your mother's womb. I sanctified thee. I ordained you, he says. I made you a prophet for the nations. So God knows you. But nowadays I see our Africans lost because they do not want to endure the preparation process with God. They do not want to go through what Jesus went through, because Jesus was prepared in order for him to die for us on the cross. Moses was prepared for him to set the Israelites free. Esther was prepared and used to get into the palace to set the Jews free. What are you doing in your preparation season? Pandora was told to walk away from getting married 8 years ago in order for her to be prepared for what God has given birth to for the world in the woman that I've become by grace. It was about the assignment. It was never about me. What am I saying to Zambia? You are probably saying to yourself, how do I activate? And how do I, excuse my voice, and how do I do and endure during my preparation? Number one, you need to be able to sing praises to the Lord. Singing opens up a doorway in heaven for God to come in, and in his presence, there's fullness of joy. Number two, how you prepare yourself through prayer. A prayer will open a doorway in the spirit. Read 1 Samuel chapter 1 verse 10. Read about Anna and how she prayed and how God did it for her. Prayer moves things in the supernatural. God reveals his plans and his will for you when you ask him in prayer. Pray to God in a language that God understands, which is the word of God. If you are saying, I do not have money, go back to God and say, but Lord, you said that you shall supply to all my needs according to your riches and glory. Challenge God with the word of God. Number three, how you are able to prepare yourself is for you to obey God. There is no testimony without a test. Number four, you prepare yourself through availability. Go to the book of Luke chapter 1 verse 38. Mary was available to carry Jesus Christ. Whatever God wants you to do, you need to be able to say, I am available to be used by you, Lord. Pandora 8 years ago said, Father God, I am walking away from all of it. I'm walking away from the money. I am walking away from getting married, which most women are dreaming of. I'm walking away from having this luxurious life and this mansion because, you see, God, I knew that He will restore me. It is not about God taking away from you. It is about you being prepared by God so that He is able to restore you in His own ways and in His time that is perfect for you. Because God says there are many plans in a man's heart, but only his will shall prevail. So I had plans in my heart, but only the will of God prevailed at the end. So I said, God, I am available to be used by you. Number five. You need to prepare yourself with your location. Read the book of Luke, chapter 1, verse 9. Location. Location matters to God. Entering His gates instead of the digital world. Go and have an encounter with God. Go and have an encounter with God in the house of the Lord. You see, even the house that God leads you to, don't choose a house of God because of there's more people in the church or you hear that the pastor is better than anyone. Allow the Holy Spirit to lead you in order for you to be able to be rooted in where God wants you. You see, you prepare yourself through your offerings and your tithes to God. Read the book of Judges chapter 13 verse 19 to 21. Offering opens doors in the supernatural. You can't put a price tag on joy, love, peace, but comes through offering to God. Sow and you shall reap what you sow. And lastly, which is number seven. I love number seven. You prepare yourself with dancing. You dance in the presence of God. When you are giving birth as a woman, when you are in the labor ward, you are dancing out of pain. And as you're dancing, this pain looks unbearable. This pain looks like it will never end. But when that baby comes, you forget about the pains. Same applies with your preparation. Same applies with your process in any season that you find yourself in right now. You need to dance and have joy in the Lord, knowing that God is with you. When you dance, you are birthing in the supernatural. You can go to 2 Samuel chapter 6, verse 14 for that. God is saying, prepare yourself with God. Prepare yourself with God. Your situation is not a surprise to God. God is with you. I am a living testimony that God is able to restore you. God moved me from the floors to a bed. God moved me from not knowing where I was going when I took a leap of faith in ministry. And God has opened many doors for me in the nations, and I am preaching this gospel. God has opened so many doors. When I look at my journey and I look at my review mirror, all I can say, no one can take the glory, but the glory belongs to God. Amen. It is by His grace that He has risen me as a different breed out of the soil of South Africa to come and reunite Africa back to God. Amen. You see, with God, all things are possible. Amen. You see, with God, He will never leave you nor forsake you. Amen. You see, with God, when you look to Him and not men, He is able to do exceedingly and abundantly and above all that you ever ask. Amen. In closing, I would like to say, seek first the kingdom of God. Amen. It's righteousness. Mm. And all these things shall be added unto you. What will be added unto you? Your marriage will be added unto you when you first seek God. Your job will be added unto you that you are seeking at home. The miracle that you are looking for, it will be added unto you. The money that you are looking for, it will be added unto you. The blessings, whatever blessing you are looking for from God. But when you seek God first, His righteousness and His kingdom, it will all be added unto you. In Jesus' name I trust and I pray for you. Amen.
Amen. That was powerful, woman of God. I think that I want to believe that there is so much that God wants to do, not just with Zambia, but with the nation. But until we prepare enough, until we have the capacity, the systems to be able to accommodate God, everything remains but in vain. And I'm grateful because the woman of God has brought it yet again. It's been my passion to tell people, prepare. There's no way you can see the hand of God unless you prepare. And that's very, very important. I'm glad that you could hear God correctly and He has used you as a voice in this program today to speak to the people. You are out there and you are saying that, woman of God, I want to prepare for God. Pandora, how do people get in touch with you? Are you doing any programs that people would like to, connect to and things like that?
excuse me. I've been running a marathon in this country.
I know.
It's been 2 weeks I've been here. Mm. I have not had rest. Mm. We just came back from Key to a 3 days conference, preaching every day.
Yeah.
This country has really stretched me in my calling with God.
Amen.
I saw that I am actually able to run a marathon and preach for 3 days nonstop. So excuse my voice.
Yeah.
I do, because for me, I minister on all platforms.
Amen.
God has given us so much.
Amen.
We've got Facebook, we've got Twitter, we've got Instagram.
Amen.
We've got so many social media platforms that God has given us.
Mm.
How are we using those platforms?
Exactly.
So if you would like to get in touch with Pandora Mabai, please do like my Facebook page.
Mm.
Go to Pandora Mabai Inspirational Speaker page and like the page. I do sincerely apologize. My personal account on Facebook, where you send friendship requests, it is full. I have reached the 5,000 limit.
Mm.
If you send me a friendship request, I will not be able to accept you. But you can be able to get onto my Pandora Mabai Inspirational Speaker page, like the page. On the page, you get daily inspirations.
Mm-hmm.
On the page, you get all the updates on the events where I am booked to go and proclaim this gospel globally.
Mm-hmm.
On the page, you get all the updates on the media platforms where I am interviewed. If you're saying that I do not have Facebook, but I would like to get hold of you, I am available on Twitter. My Twitter handle is @PMabai. I'm also available on Instagram, where I minister this gospel as well. My name on Instagram is Pandora Mabai. For those who are saying, I would like to see your live videos, I want more and I want to learn from you, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, Pandora Mabai. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, Pandora Mabai. I promise you, the videos are life-changing.
Amen.
Your life will never be the same.
Amen.
If you are saying, I do not have any of these mediums that you are giving me, but all I have is an email, I do accept emails. You are able to email me, pandoramabai@gmail.com. God bless you. Zambia, it's been great. Zambia, you have treated me well. Zambia, you have shown me the grace of God. Zambia, I have seen the humbleness of children of God. Mm-hmm. Zambia, may God bless you. Ndiyanithanda nonke ngegama lika Yesu Christu. Amen.
Amen. That was Minister Pandora blessing you this morning on The Voice on the Freshest Wave of Radio. Woman of God, I am grateful you are out there. You are saying you are blessed.